Today I will be teaching you guys how to make your very own slide gloves. So what you need for this is a pair of gloves, Velcro, this kind of sewing stuff, it's like the wire to sew, a sewing needle, a thimble, cutting board. You'll either need shoe goo or epoxy. You'll need like a bandsaw or a hacksaw to cut the cutting board. So with your sewing string, you want to cut it to a length that you'll be able to work with. I cut mine at like about an arm's length. And then, this is kind of the tedious hard part. You have to put little tiny knots in this string. You have to try to put them all together at the end to form a knot, just like that. I don't know if you can see that. So once you form that knot at the end, you want to take your string and stick it through your needle. You have to stick the end that doesn't have the knot on it through your needle. Pull it so that you have extra room like that. Now you have to take your glove and see where you'll want your Velcro to go. So I usually place the bottom piece of Velcro right about here on my palm. So just feel it with your other hand on top where you want it. You know the length, you just want to snip it with your scissors and make sure check again. Alright, now that you have it placed, you have to slip your hand out of the glove without moving the Velcro too much and take your thimble, put it on your finger, and take your needle. And put it right through your Velcro and your glove, just like so. So once you have your needle inside the glove, you have to make a stitch by moving it and then poking it right back through. So that's one part. Now we have to go back. Go right through and then go up over there. So now you have the end part of your glove stitched. Now you just have to go all the way around this Velcro piece and then you'll have one Velcro piece done. You just have to keep doing the same motion of sticking it in and pushing it back out. Now, just all the way around your glove. So this method does take longer to do than maybe gluing your puck onto your actual glove. But I found that gluing the puck onto my glove never stayed on. Lots of times I would catch an edge on my puck and it would rip my whole puck right off my glove and then that would be it. That'd be the end of sliding for the day. I did this idea. I haven't had many problems, if any at all, of the pucks ripping off the actual glove. All right, so now that you've gone around the whole edge of your Velcro around your glove, you have to do another knot that'll go just like your first knot, that'll sit right on the Velcro and ensure that your stitching will not unravel. So it should look a little bit something like this. Now that you've done all the stitching, you can make some pucks. So now with your cutting board, you can make varieties of different types of pucks. You can make round pucks, square pucks. You can do any type of puck you want. You can cut it out with a hacksaw, and then you can actually rub it along the pavement to take off the edges. That's what lots of people do. Or if you have a bandsaw, you can cut it on the bandsaw and then you can use a sander to sand it. I was using a bandsaw for these, so, but whatever works. Once you have your puck cut out and it's finished, what you have to do is take some more of your Velcro, the hook side, and cut it out to the size of your puck. What I usually do is try to cover the puck fully, so I'll do a strip there, cut it, and then do another strip a little bit lower, cut it, do another strip a little bit lower, and then cut it. This is what it could look like. Now that you have your pucks cut out, you'll need to take your epoxy, mix them together, or if you have any sort of shoe goo and marine goo, actually work quite well to stick your Velcro onto your puck. Also, if you buy a Velcro that has a sticky side, that works also for sticking onto the puck quite well. If you're using shoe goo and marine goo, at least let them dry overnight. If you're using epoxy, it'll normally say right on the squeeze bottle, 5 minute, 10 minute, 15 minute, or 30 minute, and it can go up to an hour or 2 hours. So just be aware of your dry time. After your dry time is complete and your pucks are all finished, you can stick them onto your glove where you want them. This is what my very first attempt looked like, so don't get discouraged. Keep trying them. This is the pair I use most of the time.